ago, we used to go to the nursing home, a minister friend and I, and we would go to see a church mother that was at this particular nursing home. And when we got to the nursing home, there was another lady in a room, and her name was Rosie. Well, we would speak to Rosie and try to engage her in conversation, but she would just stare at us. And she stared so mean, and she looked at us with distrust and a whole lot of dislike. And we would go back again and attend to the church mother, but Rosie, she still had this look about us. She didn't trust us, and she let us know it, and she wouldn't say anything to us, and she would just frown at us. So we would go back again, and as the time went on, we one day got there, and they were in the lunchroom. And my friend began to feed our church mother, and I asked the aide that was feeding Rosie, I said, "Do you want me to feed her?" And she jumped up really quick and handed me that spoon, and I began to feed Rosie, and Rosie would chew, and she would chew because she didn't have her teeth, and she would swallow, and then she'd wait for some more, but she just looked at us, stared us in the eye, but she didn't say anything. And she would chew, and we would wipe her mouth if she spilled food or clean her clothes off afterwards or what have you. And so we would go back, and we'd feed her again, and the next time she was a little bit more relaxed, and we just took her time and fed her. Sometimes we would do her hair and just go back and tend to her. And one day we walked in, and Rosie gave us the biggest smile, and she made a kind of a noise, a happy noise, like, and everything. And so I said, "Wow, this is so neat, you know," and she let us feed her like a child and was more trusting and everything. And when we go back again, we walked in one day and she said, "How y'all doing?" I didn't know she could talk, praise Jesus. And so we began to continue throughout our time there, our season there at the nursing home. We would just minister to Rosie and just be a blessing to Rosie. And Rosie began to bloom like a flower. Rosie, when she saw us coming in, she was so excited. She was so happy. And the Lord reminded me, he said, "Look what kindness would do." And kindness is an available key to us. And God reminded me the other day about the key of kindness. Sometimes we pass people and if not careful, we can forget. We can forget about the takeaways, or we forget to look for the takeaways. But God brought to mind the key of kindness, and that kindness still works if you work it. Kindness will open doors if you work it. Kindness will cause trees to bloom if you work it. Kindness will do miracles if you work it. Kindness has power. So I'm excited about that key, that available key that's available to you and I today. So you never know what you're gonna glean from characters that you meet along the way. All right, I'm out of here. I'm still testing. Stay tuned for more characters.